Hello and welcome to the feature of the week. The likelihood ratio test allows us to compare the likelihood of two models to decide if one is significantly better than the other. One major requirement to apply the likelihood ratio test is that the two models are nested. We say the two models are nested if one of the models is a special case of the other, or in other words, if we can turn one of the models into the other one by constraining its parameters. For example, let's consider two different structural models. Both of them contain one compartment with linear elimination and first-order absorption, but the second one has a lag time parameter. We can say that the first model is a special case of the second model, because the two models are equivalent if we set the t-lag parameter to zero. On the other hand, two models, one with first-order and one with zero-order absorption, are not nested, because neither one of them is a special case of the other. Models that are structurally the same but have a different statistical part can also be nested. For example, consider two identical structural models, one without covariates and the second one with age added as a covariate on clearance. The two models are nested because when the beta parameter is set to zero, the second model becomes identical to the first one. Now that we know what nested models are, let's see how the likelihood ratio test works. Adding more and more parameters to a model will increase its likelihood as the model will have more flexibility to feed the data. But at some point, the likelihood difference after adding an additional parameter may not seem sufficient to justify a more complex model. The likelihood ratio test helps to find out if the difference is statistically significant, or in other words, if adding a new parameter is justified. The likelihood ratio test statistic is calculated like this. In this formula, theta zero are the parameters of the simpler model and theta hat the parameters of the more complex model. The larger the difference between the two likelihoods, the more evidence we have to say that the more complex model better captures the data. But how large should the difference be to consider it significant? In the case of nested models, the likelihood ratio test follows a chi-square distribution. If we want to know whether the difference between likelihoods is significant, we need to check if the test statistic is below or above the critical value that depends on the degrees of freedom k of the chi-square distribution and the significance level alpha. The degrees of freedom correspond to the difference in the number of parameters between two models. When assessing the addition of one covariate, it is 1. The significance level corresponds to the rate of false positives I am ready to accept. It is usually set to 0.05. This means that I accept that in 5% of the cases, I will conclude that the likelihood difference is significant, while in fact it is not. Let's see how this would work on a specific example. I modeled the warfarin PK data from the demo project with a structural model with first-order absorption with T-lag, one compartment and linear elimination, and without any covariates. I run the population parameter estimation and likelihood calculation via importance sampling. In the results tab, I can see that the value of minus 2 times the log likelihood is 656.88. Now, I will try to add age as a covariate on clearance. This is now a model nested with the previous one with one additional parameter. Beta CLH. The minus 2 log likelihood decreased and is equal to 654.29. The question is if this decrease is significant. The likelihood ratio test statistic is equal to the difference between the two numbers, 2.59. Here is the table of chi-square critical values depending on the degree of freedom and the significance level. We have to find out if 2.59 is above or below the critical value for chi-square distribution with 1 degree of freedom, as the two models differ by one parameter. We can use a standard significance level of 0.05. The critical value for 1 degree of freedom and the significance level of 0.05 is 3.84. Since the difference in minus 2 log likelihoods is lower than 3.84, we can conclude that the difference is not statistically significant, and we will choose the model without the covariate. Monolix has automatic procedures of adding covariates and checking if it leads to a significant decrease in the likelihood. In the Automatic Model Building tab, the COSAC and SCM strategies add or remove covariates one by one. At each step, the likelihood ratio test is used to decide if the covariate addition is significant and capped or not. These procedures will be presented in more detail in another video. Thank you for watching and have a nice week.